Many of you active in the plastic industry have already experienced the following. Your quality engineer is coming to you with the problem that he has to scrap all parts because they are out of tolerance due to warpage. But by using them in an assembled state, it seems that they are functionally correct and don't need to be scrapped. A problem that sometimes gives you gray hair, but a problem where we have an answer to. Hi, my name is Toon from GOM. I'm here at the Polymer Center in Charlotte, North Carolina, and today we're going to talk about 3D scanning and what the future of plastic inspection looks like with the use of our new powerful software feature, DWARP. This function will help you bypass the problem in a smart and effective way. We all know plastic parts, either injection molded or 3D printed, are subject to an annoying behavior, warpage. This is the unwanted deformation of the part caused by this production process. Let us look at plastic injection molding. This is a complex production process. Even with the best simulation software and complex mold correction, the resulting parts will most likely still be warped. For good quality control, warpage is quite challenging. On the one hand, it may be helpful to identify and quantify the overall warpage, which occurs in an unassembled state, for example, for the toolmaker. But up to a certain degree, global warpage is not a functional problem. Here's the thing. Plastic parts don't act alone. They're almost always part of an assembly. What we actually want to know is, will this part perform its function once it is assembled? Up until now, the only conventional way of compensating for warpage during measurements was to physically clamp the part. These fixtures forces the part into an overconstrained state that simulates the assembly situation. Unfortunately, there are at least a few problems with this way of working. It obstructs the part from easily being measured. Fixtures are expensive and need to be maintained on a regular basis, and therefore you might not have them. And information from the unassembled state is lost. If only there was a way to digitally dewarp the part after having it easily scanned in an unassembled state. Well, the latest version of GOM Inspect Pro offers an easy solution called dewarp. With DWARP, you can put your scanned part into a virtually assembled state with just one push of a button. This allows you to check the dimensions as if the part was already finally assembled. Let's have a look at this complete process. Whether you have a new part to be scanned or an already scanned part, this free state mesh provides a lot of useful information, especially for the toolmaker. But I am going to take this inspection to the next level by removing warpage of the mesh. This happens in two steps. First, the software generates a deformation model. This is a mathematical model based on the material properties and the CAD file. Next, we need to define which points are used to assemble this part, so the software knows where to apply the virtual forces. In our case, the top and the bottom cover will be assembled using these 9 screws. Using all of that information enables the GOM software to run a finite element-based deformation of the virtual part. This means that the digital twin will be adapted and all inspection results will automatically be recalculated. So the software does the job for you. As this is a purely digital process, you can easily switch the results between the assembled and the unassembled state, allowing you to get all the information you need for your evaluation. And there you go. No need to falsely scrap parts, no need for cumbersome fixtures, and all the information you want just using the GOM Inspect Pro software. For more inspiring videos, please go to handsonmetrology.com. Thanks for watching and have fun bringing your inspection to the next level.